Hello children, welcome to the maths class. My dear students, already we have started chapter 1. The name of the chapter is Operations on Large Number. We have already discussed few topics. Now, today we are going to discuss about division. Children, today we are going to discuss what is dividend, what is divisor, what is quotient and how to do division using long division method. Children, let us understand one by one. The number which we divide is called the dividend. As you can see here, 2333 is given as dividend here. Now the second one is the number by which we divide. Now here the number by which we divide is 9. So 9 is the divisor here. Now the third is the result obtained is called the quotient. Now the result in the sense here, as you can see, 259 is the result. So that is called the quotient. Now the number which left after division, as you can see here, 0 is left over after division. So 0 is called as remainder. Children, now see the four steps. Using these steps, you can divide any number. So let's talk about the first alphabet which we use is capital D. So it's D stand for divide. Now the second alphabet is M. M stand for multiply. Then the third alphabet that we use is S. S stands for subtract, and the last is B. B stands for bring down. Children, before doing the sum, you need to understand what is long division. Let's discuss. Long division is a way to solve division problem with large number. As you know, we are discussing about large numbers. So if in the sum the dividend and divisor is given large number in the sense more than 2 or 3 digit, so that type of sum you will solve using long division method. Now see, after division, how you will check whether your answer is correct or not? So this is a method to check your answer. Here, if dividend is equals to divisor multiplied with quotient, and whatever product will be there, you have to add with the remainder. If your answer is equal to dividend, it means your sum is correct. Children, now let's see how we'll use long division method with the help of example. 69,834 is divided by 343. Here, 69,834 is given as dividend and 343 is given as divisor. Before starting the division, we have to list out the multiples of divisor. Here in divisor, the number is given 343. So first you need to list out all the multiples of 343 till 10. Like 343 into 1 is equals to 343. 343 into 2 is equals to 686. In this way, already I have listed multiples till 10. Now we'll start the division. The first step. Whenever you are starting the division, the first number you have to see the number which is given on left side, extreme left side. So as you can see in dividend, dividend is 69,834. So the left side number is given 6. 6 is smaller than 343. So when the number is smaller than the divisor, then we'll put 0 as quotient. And 0 as here, we'll write 343 into 0 is equals to 0. So now the second step is we'll subtract. As you can see, 343 multiplied with 0. 0 we have written as quotient, and 0 will be here because any number, if we will be multiply with any number, the answer will be 0. So 343 into 0 is equals to 0. Now the second step, subtraction. So 0 is subtracted from 69. This is also property of 0. If we will subtract 0 from any number, the answer will be number itself. Now here 69 will get. Now the second step is, now again 69 is smaller than 343. It means again dividend is smaller than divisor. Again we repeat the same method. 0 will write in quotient and here also 0 will write. Now subtraction, 0 will be subtracted from 69. Now 69 will write as it is. Now we'll bring down the next digit, which is given 8 here. 8 will bring down. Now the number will become 698. Now we'll see the number in the multiples. See, 343 into 2 here is 686. So 2 will write here in quotient and 686 will write here. Now the next step is subtraction. 6 minus 8 will be 2 and 9 minus 8 will be 1. So here 12 is the remainder. Now the next digit is 3, that will bring down here. So now the number is 123. Again, now dividend is smaller than divisor. So we'll repeat again, we'll write 0 in quotient and here also we'll write 0. After subtraction, we'll get the same number 123. Now we'll bring the next digit, which is given 4 here, and here the number will become 1234. Now we'll see 343 into 3 is equals to 1029. So we'll use 3 here, we'll write 3 in quotient and 1029 here, and the last we'll subtract. 4 is smaller than 9, so we'll borrow 10. It will become 14. 14 minus 9 is equals to 5. Here 3 will become 2, so 2 minus 2 will be 0, and here 2 will write as it is. So now the remainder is 205. So answer will be, we'll write quotient is equals to 203 and remainder is 205. Now how we'll check whether our answer is correct or not? How we'll check? So here is the method. As you can see, this is the formula that we use to check our answer. Divisor is multiplied with quotient and added with the remainder. So 343 is multiplied with 203 plus added with remainder 205. After doing the calculation, we have got 69,834. Now we'll compare. As you can see here dividend is given 69,334. It means our answer is correct. Our method of long division is correct. Children, now let us take one more example. 7,30,525 is divided by 81. So this is our second sum. We are going to understand how it is done. 81 is given as divisor and 7,30,500 is given as dividend. So the first step, we have to list out all the multiples, like I have already listed here. In this way you will do. Here are the multiples. 81 into 2 is equals to 162. 81 into 3 is equals to 243. 81 into 4 is equals to 324. 81 into 5 is equals to 405. 81 into 6 is equals to 486. So in this way till 10, we'll write the multiples. Now the next step, we'll see the number which is given on left side and it's 7. 7 is smaller than 81. Okay, so here what we'll do, we'll write 0 in quotient, and here 0 is multiplied with 81, so answer will be 0. Now we'll subtract. So 0 is subtracted from 73. After subtraction, the number which we'll get is 73. Now we'll bring the next digit, which is given 0 here. So when we'll bring 0, the number will become 730. Now 81 into 9 is equals to 729, which is smaller than 730. So we'll write 9 here in quotient and 729 here. Now the next step is subtraction. So here 0 is smaller than 9, so we'll borrow 10. Now 10 minus 9 will be 1. Only 1 is the remainder here. Now the next digit we'll bring down, which is given 5. 5 is the next number here. So 5 will bring down, the next number will be 15. As 15 is smaller than 81, so what we'll do? Same method, 0 will be written in quotient and 0 will be written here also. 0 is subtracted from 15, we'll get again 15. Now next digit will bring, which is given here 2. So 2 will bring down. Now the dividend is 152. As you can see here, 81 into 2 is equals to 162. So we cannot write 2 here. So we'll write 1. 81 into 1 is equals to 81. Now subtraction, 2 minus 1 will be 1. 5 is smaller than 8, so we'll borrow 10. It will become 15. 15 minus 8 will be 7. So now the remainder is 71. Now the last number is given 5. That will bring down. And the number is 715 now. Here 81 into 8, as you can see, 648. That we'll write 81 into 8 is equals to 648. And the last step is subtraction. 5 is smaller than 8, so we'll borrow 10. 15 minus 8 is equals to 7. Here it will become 0. Now 0 is smaller than 4. So here we'll borrow, it will become 10. 10 minus 4 is equals to 6. And here 6 minus 6 will be 0. So as you can see, remainder is 67. So this is the answer. Question is 9018 and remainder is 67.